So here we have the law of partial pressures and what it describes. So you have it right here. Now, how was this calculation obtained? Okay, I would show you right away. So I'm going to erase this part, and then I would just take you to the smart board presentation. So you have that in one mole, a total, okay, the end total here is like one mole in this case. So your total pressure is going to be the 600, okay? So doing this right here for the values that we have, I have a one mole total is 600 kilopascals. And then we're saying the partial pressure of, let's say, CO2, okay, the P of the CO2 is going to be, how many moles do I have here? 0.25, yes? It will be 0.25 moles. So, or the number of moles, I'm sorry, let me put the number of moles of CO2, okay, and then I would put the value, N of the CO2. So here I have the pressure of the CO2, and the N of the CO2 is 0.25, okay? So what you get is the pressure of the CO2 in this case is going to be 600 times 0.25, okay? So in other words, it will be the number of moles times the total pressure divided by the total number of moles, okay? Divided by the one mole. If the total number of moles was more than one, then you would actually have to put that value there, okay? So you may have a little question based on this. This is essentially the most interesting, the most important part. I will give you a little problem right now. I'm going to write it down and I will solve it. So we have a pretty good idea as to what to do, okay? So let's see. I'm erasing it, right? Are we good? Okay. In a gas cylinder, we have 0.8 moles of CO2, 0.9 moles of nitrogen, 0.2 moles of oxygen, and 0.3 moles, I'm exaggerating, but okay, of hydrogen gas. The total pressure is 1,200 kilopascals. Pretty big one. Determine the partial pressure pressures of, let's say, just oxygen and nitrogen gas. In other words, I would just simply ask these two gases. I could be asking for everything, okay? So how would we go about that problem? First of all, we know the total pressure, yes? So the total pressure is 1,200 kilopascals. Okay. The total moles, the end total, it will equal what? Well, you have to add everything that we have here, yes? So the end total I would also mark it there because it's going to be much easier. We have a 0.8, a plus a 0.9, plus 0.2, plus 0.3. Okay? So this gives me 2.2 moles. Okay? So this is 2.2 moles. So now if I want to find, first of all, the oxygen, right? How would I do this? Let's put the oxygen with blue, okay? So the pressure, partial pressure of the oxygen gas is going to have to be, as we said before, the total pressure, okay? So we're getting, are you okay doing it this way directly or having the ratio, doing the ratio? I'll just go with the ratio first, you know, so you actually see it a little easier. So if you have 2.2 moles, you have 1,200 kilopascals, okay? So the pressure of the oxygen, you put the pressure of the pressure, it will be what, given that the number of moles of the oxygen is 0.2, okay? So that is essentially how you could go about it. So the pressure of the oxygen gas, the partial pressure, it will be the 0.2 over 2.2. And I prefer to put it this way because that is essentially the portion of the pressure, right? Of the moles, I'm sorry, times the 1,200. So this will give you 0.2 times 1,200 divided by 2.2. So we get 109.1 kPa, kilopascals. So you could do a similar thing for the case of the nitrogen. The only difference in the case of nitrogen, you will have to put the 0.9 here as opposed to the 0.2, okay? So in the case of nitrogen, I'm going to do it. Let me erase. Are we okay with this? It's marked? Okay.
Yes.
So here in the case of the nitrogen, you will have 0.9 over 2.2. It will equal the pressure of the nitrogen over 1,200. And of course here, pressure of the nitrogen, it will be the 0.9 times 100 divided by 2.2. And we have 490.9. kilopascals. Are we okay so far?
Huh? Yes.
Okay, so I'm going to take you very quickly because this is essentially the most important part, right? I will present something from the screen. Okay, so let me just see if I can take you here. Okay, can you see here the screen of the law of partial pressures?
Yes.
With the containers, okay. Do you really need to have all this? Well, yes and no. I used to give it and, you know, sort of give an indication as to how this law is coming about. You see that the P total equals the sum of the partial pressures, okay? However, I think at this particular point, whatever you have, it will be okay. I will give you